Praise be to Jesus. Good morning, friends. Today, 31st of December, the last day of the year 2020. We have the Gospel reading, Luke chapter 13, verses 6 to 9. Parable of the barren fig tree. Jesus told us a parable. In the parable, the owner of an orchard, vineyard, comes to see the vineyard. And he finds that one fig tree planted in the vineyard is not yielding any fruit. The Lord has been coming to the tree for the last 3 years, but it did not produce any fruit. Now he is asking the gardener to cut it away, because it is wasting the land. And the gardener said, I will till around the tree, put manure, and let me wait for another year. If it produces some fruits, it is well. Otherwise, you can cut it off. When we look into the meaning of this parable, we know that it is about each and every one of us. The Lord has been showering His choicest blessings upon us. And the Lord has been looking for fruits every year, every moment. He is looking for fruits from us. But we are like that barren fig tree, not producing anything at all. And the Lord has given us time again. And He has given us one more year, that was 2020. And we have come to the end of the year. We must be first of all grateful to the Lord for all the blessings and graces that He has been showering upon us. Then we must repent of our frailties, our shortcomings, because we have not produced enough fruits. And then we must put our trust in the Lord and work hard so that we may become fruitful. Time is a great gift that the Lord has given us. The whole life is on the continuum of time and space. Two axes are there. All our activities are in these two axes, time and space. When we look at any of our activities, two questions come. When, where? We need time and space. And the greatest gift that the Lord has given us is the time. When there is time and space, we can act on this earth. And how we have been using our time and the space that the Lord has given us, it's a question mark before us. Every minute, every second, every moment of our life is precious. It is through these realities of time and space that we achieve something, or that we perform what the Lord wants us to do, that we become fruitful. As we are at the conclusion of the year, on this 31st of December, let us be once again aware of our need to work for the Lord, our need to make use of our time fruitfully, and to make our life useful for others and fruitful for us. Lord, we thank you for the year. We thank you for the graces that you have been showering upon us. We offer to you the whole coming year so that we may make use of the time given to us fruitfully. Amen.